Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We have a small piece of SpaceX news to look at first in this video. An article was posted recently by Space News with SpaceX being awarded a new contract. The company will be given $150 million to launch as many as 28 satellites for the Space Development Agency. It says the agency estimates the satellites will be ready to launch in late 2022. We have a few bits in Boca Chica. The construction around the orbital launch pad is continuing. Here's a closer look at some of the work. Some shipping containers were also seen being placed over there. A new mobile office building was placed next to the bunker structures. For this video, we have a lot of tweets related to Super Heavy, starting with somebody who tweeted an animation of Super Heavy landing to Elon Musk. Musk responded with some big info regarding the booster by saying, "We're going to try and catch the Super Heavy booster with the launch tower arm using the grid fins to take the load." In response, he was asked a bunch of questions such as, "What implications does this have for droneship landings? Or will all Starship drone ships essentially be fully fledged ocean spaceports including launch mount?" He responded to that and just said yes. In another tweet, Musk was asked, "Will precision or stability of landing be the same or even better than with legs?" He responded with, "Saves mass and cost of legs and enables immediate repositioning of booster onto launch mount ready to refly in under an hour." There was another tweet where somebody asked him, "Too much material stress on the landing legs for it to land on the pad by itself?" He responded to that and said, "Legs would certainly work, but best part is no part, best step is no step." Somebody commented on the previous question and tweeted, "Or he wants to undesign the legs." Musk once again just responded with yes. People have raised concerns about catching the booster with the launch tower using the grid fins. Somebody in a thread tweeted, "Yeah, you could build shock absorbers into the launch stand's arms without having to worry about any weight penalty." Musk responded with, "Exactly." Finally, for the Super Heavy tweet, somebody made and posted an animation of how the launch tower could work to catch the booster. Musk gave some more information on the launch tower by saying, "Rocket motion is primarily vertical, so you want the top open." So now, looking at Starship Pieces, the new nose cone was seen moved outside recently. It was not long before it was moved back inside. With Starships progressing, some new flaps were seen arriving. For SN8, some large pieces such as the nose cone still remain on the landing pad. Looking at some SN9 related tweets now, Musk was asked about the header tank problem that caused SN8's demise. More specifically, he was asked what exactly had to be addressed to keep the methane tank from losing pressure. Musk responded with, "SN9 will press methane header tank with helium. Long-term solution is under debate, not clear what is lightest or simplest." In response to the switch to helium, Everyday Astronaut also tweeted, "Whoa, so you made the switch to helium that quickly between SN8 and SN9. Amazing that you can just make adjustments on the fly." Musk responded and said, "Production is hard, prototypes are easy. Building approximately 1,000 starships to create a self-sustaining city on Mars is our mission." SN9 recently completed a couple of proof tests and is now being prepared to fire the engines. As always, taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, the dates remain unchanged. We still have a primary date of tomorrow when I'm hoping they will perform a static fire. However, with backup dates on Tuesday and Wednesday, we can possibly expect a bunch of tests this coming week. SN10's nose cone was still hanging out in the high bay as they worked on the tank section. Since then, SN10's nose has been stacked and we now have another full-size Starship. Musk was asked about the possibility of seeing SN9 and SN10 both sitting on the pad together in the next few weeks. He said yes, which is super exciting. "We saw SN11's tank section stacked last video and looks like the first piece of SN12 is also in the midbay now." Thanks to Brendan Lewis once again for creating an up-to-date Starship and Super Heavy status diagram. We now have two fully stacked Starships and a whole bunch of other prototypes in the works. I always finish my videos by saying thanks to Mary or Boca Chica Gal for her time and dedication filming this awesome Starship stuff. Plus, a thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes to bring us the best space coverage. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.